Alright, so I got in my new planner. Y'all know that I have been loving the passion planner for several years now. And I got my planner in yesterday and I have been in it ever since, trying to set it up. I started by opening it up, smelling all the pages. And as I worked on my vision board and my roadmap, which I love this planner, I think I'm getting the hiccups and my hiccups are the worst. Anyway, if alone just for the prompts and the vision roadmaps that they include, but I'm doing something a little different with it this year with the tour and all the things that we have planned or scheduled or dreaming of doing this year. And so I thought I would just sit down and answer one question that I thought was an incredible question that kind of sort of has a lot to do with vision and dreams and goals. Yeah, let me just, I'll just start with the question. So this question I love. It's actually from one of my favorite Falco family friends, Robin. And this is what she says. Have you always been a goal setter and a dreamer by nature? It's an interesting topic for me, and I think it sometimes comes from how we were raised. My parents were hard workers and homebodies and work hard every day, go to church, and repeat. I feel like I didn't grow up with big dreams except to have a family and be a mom. I want to dream more for our family, but I don't know where to start. This may seem like a weird question to ask someone who is a dreamer naturally, but it is real for me. This year for me is different in the sense that I have an urgency for change, for something different for myself and my family. I don't want to just survive, I want to thrive. Any kind of advice would be great if you can understand where I'm going with this. Okay, first of all, I totally understand where you're going. Wow, I have been thinking about this question for quite some time and wanted to answer it. First of all, I think I have always been a dreamer. And I do agree that it comes naturally for me. However, the part that I feel like I don't necessarily agree with is the idea that it doesn't come naturally to you. I am 110% convinced that dreaming comes naturally to all of us, but somewhere along the way it gets lost. And I think some of us have personalities that lend itself to holding on to vision and to dreams. I feel like I didn't grow up with big dreams except to have a family and be a mom. When you say it is to have a family and be a mom, that's a thing for me, because when we reduce it to just a family and a mom, I think you limit yourself. Because for me, my family and being a mom and a wife is the dream. It's just that I sit with the dream long enough for it to sprout wings, and I put enough work and effort behind it for it to fly. We are told what we should think and what we should become, and I think that is the very thing that starts to kill our creativity and our ability to dream. I want to dream more for our family, but I don't know where to start. No matter how small the dream may be, and most of us here, that dream has been in the form of homeschool. You have a dream education that is catered more to their strengths and abilities, to give them a beautiful chance and environment under which they can thrive. That is a dream, and it may start as a small seed, and the more that you water it and the more space and time that you give it to grow, the more it does grow. Does that make sense? Basically what I'm trying to say is I think that all dreams start as a small seed. I spend a tremendous amount of time thinking and praying and working towards the dreams that I have for our family and our homeschool. So much time. Most of which are not really rewarded by or given instant gratification, if that makes any sense. And that's a lot of my struggle. in making videos, in moving forward in homeschool. I don't want to just survive. I want to thrive, and it's not commonplace for me. I read one book. It's basically like my manual for success in this little dream of ours. Look, it's all completely tattered and worn out and well-loved on and highlighted and all that. And it's called The Richest Man Who Ever Lived, King Solomon's Secret to Success, Wealth, and Happiness. When it comes to not just wanting to survive, I 110% feel every bit of that. In the section about vision, talks about it being a matter of life and death. In the word, it says that without vision, people perish. It's so important for you to have well-defined visions in your personal and professional life. It's so important that without it, our innermost being will begin to waste away. The joy of living becomes replaced with the mere act of surviving or just getting by. Where there is no vision, the people perish. I think in any area of life, whether it's in marriage, whether it is in education, in homeschool, being a mom, you start with a vision of what type of mom you wanna be, or what type of wife you wanna be, or what type of teacher you wanna be. I think that at some point along the way in being taught what to think or what to be in this world, we forget what is natural to us, which is dreaming. Vision really is about taking that dream and giving it more fuel. I am quickly learning that that fuel is hope. You have a hope that you will see certain things come of your family and your life and your career, and you get closer to that dream by creating goals and moving towards them. But unfortunately, we get stuck and we become complacent. Complacency is when you are fine where you are despite any deficiencies. And to me, that doesn't give any room for growth. Complacency is totally different from contentment. Be content with where you are. Be grateful for what you have, but keep dreaming. That's what I tell myself. I want to grow, and if that means a mom, a wife, a homeschool mom who creates tours so that their kids can get pumped and excited about exploring the world. That is the best me that I am looking to be. I think that it's a mistake that we make to think that we're not naturally dreamers. We are. It's just that some of us let go of that part of us too soon and too easily. But please know that there's a lot of things that I sacrifice in order to give myself time and space to truly listen to the vision, meditate on the vision that God has put in my heart, and intentionally take steps in order for my hope to grow in that area. And then to walk in love. You know, love is patient, it's kind, it's long-suffering, it doesn't boast, it never gives up. For me, one of the things that has threatened my vision is provision. The fear of not having enough is real. So, my camera definitely cut off on me. I think that once we have a vision, it's important to write it down. Actually, the word says that, and that is what I do. I have notebooks full of different things that I see for our family. Some of those things have come to pass and some of them haven't, but I still have hope that it will all work out together and it will all be good. We have to get back to dreaming bigger. Another thing I wanna say is that dreaming bigger is not always what it seems. Unfortunately, we have allowed a lot of the messages and pieces of other people's lives through social media that we see on a daily basis to become a standard of what we are to dream. And I think that that needs to be challenged. A big dream for us could be so small to someone else. I have spoken about vision and dreaming big and all that stuff. You know I love to talk about that. And every time I talk about it in one way, shape, or form, I always get some type of communication or comment, something to the effect that their dream is simply just being a mom, or something that the way they state it seems like it's super small. But I want to try and be clear. My dream is absolutely just that. My dream is my family and being a good mom and being the best Syreena that I was born to be. That is my dream. So when we talk about things like wanting to produce our first film or write a book, that is at the root being the best mom that I can be, using the gifts that I have been given, the gifts that we have been given together as a family. Those things are part of that simple dream. That's really not so simple. Caring for your family, nurturing your family, striving every day to be a better wife, to be a better teacher, to be a better friend. Those things that seem simple and small and of little significance because there is no reward, those things are what matter to me the most. And my biggest fight is fighting that temptation that is what we are to strive for. I fight every day. Because it's not what I want. What I want is something that others probably will never be able to see, and that's true contentment and happiness and joy and peace and wisdom. They are part of our vision, and I'm going to move towards that more and more every day. So yeah, if you feel that sense of urgency to want more for your family, I challenge you to sit and figure out what that more is. Because more isn't bad. More is a part of growth. But being okay with the time and the work and the effort and the rest that it might take to get there is what I try to work on. So yeah, I've seen this vision for this tour in my heart for a long time. I don't know how it's going to pan out. It may not be as spectacular as other social media traveling families are, but what I want is for the reward to be rich. Rich in joy and peace and just really living every day of our lives, giving of ourselves and our gifts and doing better. Being better and spreading and sharing love and extending love to ourselves and to one another. That is part of my vision and my dream. And it becomes more and more clear as I take more steps towards that. But start with whatever seemingly small dream that you feel like you've been given, and then give it some time and some space and some water, some fuel to grow. I sit in front of my planner often and I just think, void of other people's thoughts or opinions or images of what they are doing in their lives. And I think that's another thing that's really hard for us to discipline ourselves to do nowadays, because it is so easy to pop onto some sort of social platform and see all the things that others are doing. But it doesn't give us much space for us to see ourselves and what is ahead for us and what we are doing. That is really important to me, and why memories are important to me, because memories allow you to see yourself and your family, and it's a perspective that you don't often see. And that is why giving your vision space and room to grow is so important, because we've been given these eyes that see this one perspective, the ability to see others. But sometimes we need to see ourselves. And the more we see ourselves, the more you can see where you'd like to keep going, or where you'd like to keep stretching, and where you'd like to keep growing. And so that's why memories are so important to me. That's why I'm here in this space, because I love keeping our memories and I love seeing our growth. And it isn't truly about the destination, and that's the ultimate temptation or the trick, right? Because it is about all the beautiful things in the journey. So yeah, whether you were raised in a family of dreamers, or what matters is knowing that we are all given a dream or a vision for our lives, and giving that attention is really important, because what you tend to or give attention to will grow. And I give a lot of attention to our dream, and I make things that don't seem like they're a thing an actual thing. Like, I have actual business cards for my children in their homeschool. It's an absolute thing. So if you feel an urgency for change, it's because it's time. It's time for you to give the dream that you have been given more attention. I hope this makes some kind of sense. We're always changing. We're always growing. We should be. For me, the goal is to give those things attention and to always just work at them and not quit. So I'm gonna get back to my planner. I mapped out my very first game changer goal for this month, which is to develop a strong family rhythm or routine. I really need to do that now that we made the change and jumped over into more of an unschooling way of life. I still need to establish a rhythm and what that is going to look like for us. So I've spent quite a bit of time dreaming that up. And it may or may not work the way I envision it in my mind, but I have to start from there. And so I gave that dream a goal, which is to develop a rhythm. And all of its bits and pieces I've written out, from the morning routine to the night routine to assigning responsibilities, the chore charts, the reward charts. I've written all of those things down, and then I've given it a date, the 31st of the month. So by writing it down, making it a goal, assigning tasks, and then giving it a date, it gives me something very, very clear and concrete to work towards, and that's what vision is. And so as I work towards that, it'll give me more hope and more fuel to take the next step. I don't know. I feel like this was all over the place, but I'm trying. I'm just sharing some of my thoughts and feelings and reasons as to why we're doing this thing that we're doing with the Live and Learn Tour and anything we do in the Falco family. I just want the kids to see our family as individual and special, and for them to have a strong understanding of their place in this world. All right, I'm gonna get back to thank you again, Robin, for asking such a beautiful question. There is already a dream in your heart and a vision that has been given to you, and I would suggest that you would give that what it needs to grow. And I'm looking forward to celebrating with you along the way. So, bye.